So here's our consumer. Here's print, posters, this kind of thing. TV came in, radio, what do we have? Digital, online, all kinds of SMS, social media, and then whatever the latest thing is that's going to kill everything else and media will never be the same again. Yeah, it's always changing like that, media. Do you notice one thing on there that isn't changing? The person in the middle. That's your media. These things are just channels to get to your media. If you want to go viral, you don't go viral here, you go viral there. If you look at history, if viral was years before there even was any digital, before there was any TV, before there was any radio, before Caxton things went viral. Things went viral because people talked about them. It's called viral because it spreads by people, the way flu spreads. It spreads by word of mouth, by people picking it up, people singing it, people passing it along. And if they haven't got email or YouTube to pass it along, they'll pass it along by singing it in the street. I used to hear songs from my mum and dad that they learned when they were little kids from the music hall. Viral happens there. In the 55 million little units of that, these are just triggers for us to get to that. So how do we trigger that? If that's really what can increase the value of what we do, how do we get to that? So, I'm not going to draw on you. So how do we get to that? How does that work? Okay. Bill Birnbach, if any of you have studied, the guy who invented good advertising was a guy called Bill Birnbach. And up until Bill Birnbach, it was all the same old kind of patronising crap that you see on Mad Men. Bill Birnbach was the guy who invented good advertising, and anything else has been footnotes to Bill Birnbach. Bill Birnbach said, what we deal in is simple, timeless human truths. So what's a simple, timeless human truth about the way our media works? Okay. So, and remember, the power is in simplicity, not complexity. So although a lot of this will feel uncomfortably simple for you, the power is in simplicity. From the day you're born till the day you die, every communication you make must have three elements. It must have impact, it must communicate, and it must be persuasive. That's not hard work, is it? And it must work that way around. Every communication you make from the day you're born to the day you die must have those three elements. If you don't have any impact, fuck all happens. If you have impact but nobody knows what you want, again, the square root of fuck all happens. If you have impact, people know what you want, but they don't see any reason they should do it, nothing happens. You have to have all three things. A baby, when it's born, it cries. It cries to get on impact, obviously. If it doesn't cry, its mother won't pay any attention. It cries, its mother looks at it and sees, is it going blue, is it going yellow, is it going green, does it need changing, is its nappy full, does it want feeding, does it need burping? His mother will work out what it wants, and because it's his mum, she'll do whatever the baby needs. She's persuaded it needs to happen. That's simple human. People have just decided, just discovered that advertising is a conversation. All right, that's every conversation you ever have in your life. Advertising works the same way every other one does. If I sit at home and I'm watching the TV with the wife and I want her to make me a cup of tea, it's no good me sitting there concentrating like mad, sending out thought waves. It doesn't work. What I have to do, I have to say, you know, nothing happens. I have to say, Kath, I'm on the radar. She'll say, yeah. And at that point, it's no good me saying to her, ich klomme die Jani geha umbesprachen. I've got to say to her, in a language she understands, make us a cup of tea. Now, so far, she doesn't, you know, we've got the beginnings of a conversation, but nothing's going to happen until we get to a point. So I've got to say, Kath, if you make us a cup of tea, I'll put the garbage out. Now, if she's persuaded that that's a good deal, we've got a conversation. That's how ads work. Exactly the same as everything else. And what we see from the numbers we've just looked at is 90% of advertising fails there. Better than 90%. Fails at impact, doesn't even get on the radar. 4% remember positively, 7% remember negatively, 89% not noticed or remembered. Everybody concentrates on the 7% that's remembered negatively. That's not the problem, at least that works. The 89% is the problem there. And yet all of our concentration, every bit of our concentration is down here on persuasion. We automatically assume everybody's going to see our ads. So we concentrate on focus groups, 12 women in slough, loads and loads of planners. We put all of our effort down there and wonder why 17 billion quid is pissed away. And a billion quid actually works.